we have seen the working of black and white television receiver. Now today I will tell you how exactly the color television works practically. Okay, before that, you might have studied all these things, but oral exam point of view, the things which are required, the minute details, today I will try to cover that in this session. So now all of you give attention. Now, if you see this compatibility consideration, 6 marks theory question is normally asked on this compatibility consideration. So what is it? See this. This is a color camera, the upper portion, and the lower is black and white camera. At the right upper side, you will see it is color picture tube, and here it is black and white picture tube. So color television receiver, black and white television receiver. This is color transmitter and this is black and white transmitter. So why these 4 combinations shown over here? The basic reason is, in past we were having only black and white camera. Okay, there after this color camera and color transmission comes into picture. In past only black and white televisions were there before 25 years. There after color television came into market. So initially only black and white transmission was there and black and white reception was there. But thereafter color transmission and color receiver came into market, and accordingly the compatibility considerations were considered to be important. So what is the reason? Initially they were transmitting only black and white signal and they were receiving black and white television receiver. They were receiving the signal on black and white television receiver. But let us say color transmission and color television, they came into market simultaneously. So what is this compatibility consideration? Though color transmission is there, color picture should be observed on color television receiver, but black and white television you cannot throw out. So if the color transmission is there and if your receiver is black and white, then black and white picture should be observed. That was the condition, and right now also this is a condition. Those who are having old black and white television, though color transmission and broadcast is going on, they are receiving the signal and they are showing as a black and white signal. And if you consider a color television receiver, then if the color signal is being transmitted, then it will be observed as a colored signal on your television receiver. So now all of you attention, what is this compatibility consideration? I will explain it in 2 lines. If the color transmission is going on, the picture should be observed as a color on color receiver. If the color transmission is going on, it should be observed black and white on black and white television. Second thing is, if the black and white transmission is going on, it should be observed black and white on black and white receiver. And if the black and white transmission is going on, though color receiver is there with you, the signal should be, or the picture should be observed as a black and white. It's quite natural. So when this condition arrives, when the flashback type of scenes are there, the transmission becomes black and white. Okay, sometimes. And some recordings, old recordings are there, they're black and white. So if the black and white transmission is going on, and if you want to observe it on color television, then it should be observed as a black and white. So this is called as compatibility consideration. So now, what are the requirements? All of you give attention. So what are the color compatibility requirement? So first thing is, the color and black and white signal should meet the following requirements. Which are those requirements? Number one, it should occupy the same bandwidth as a corresponding monochrome signal. The location, see this. This is AM VHB modulated video. Audio is frequency modulated and color is QAM modulated. So the color came afterwards. But the bandwidth for one channel was decided that it's 7 megahertz according to international standards. You cannot change the channel bandwidth. So when the color transmission or camera was invented, okay, it was decided that as far as channel spectrum is concerned, somehow you have to adjust these color frequencies in the given spectrum without disturbing black and white as well as audio signal. Because at that time, 100% consumers, they did not purchase 25 years before. All consumers, they did not purchase the color television. So what was the important? Though color transmission was started 25 years back, the signal should be received and should be processed with the black and white receiver. Please keep this in your mind. Okay. So what is important thing is, though this color spectrum is available, okay, black and white television was receiving the signal without any interference. Accordingly, the color signal was transmitted. Color signal should have the same luminance, brightness information as would a monochrome signal. Okay, transmitting the same. The composite color signal should contain color information together with luminance in a such a way that it can decode very easily at a receiver. Very simple, no? Because when the color transmission started, at that time color receiver as well as black and white television receivers were there. So there should not be an interference of transmitted color signal in black and white. And color signal should be properly processed and should be observed on your color television. The color information should be carried in a such a way that it does not affect the picture reproduced on a screen of monochrome receiver. Just now we discussed. The system must employ the same deflection frequencies and sync signal as used for the monochrome transmission of reception. So if you compare the black and white as well as color transmission, then you will immediately understand that the spectrum is going to remain same. Only this color signal is added separately. QAM modulated color signal is added separately within a same spectrum. Please try to keep this in your mind. And the second thing is, all the control signal along with pure video signal, we have already seen in our laboratory that only pure video signal is not transmitted. Along with the video signal, you have H sync pulse, V sync pulse, H blanking pulse, V blanking pulse, and so on. So all these details, they are going to remain same whether the transmission is black and white or whether the transmission is color. Please keep this in your mind. Synchronization and blanking pulses, they are, and their standards, timing, frequency, they are going to remain same whether it is black and white transmission or color transmission. Now give attention. As far as color transmission is concerned, now you can see this is the spectrum, electromagnetic spectrum, in which if you see 10 raised to 10 above, 10 raised to 12, 13, and 10 raised to 15, in this specific range, you will find a visible range. And if you consider it in the terms of lambda, then it is changing from 380 nanometer to 780 nanometer. Please keep this in your mind. So your entire color transmission or black and white transmission or visible signal transmission is in the range of 380 nanometer to 780 nanometer. Also, if you see 380 nanometer, around violet color is there and its lambda is 380 nanometer. And if you say red and a related signal, then it is coming to 780 nanometer. So what this spectrum indicates, that your eye cannot see below 380 nanometer signal and above 780 nanometer signal. Because after red, infrared starts, and after violet, ultraviolet starts. Ultraviolet and infrared, these two signals cannot be seen by our eyes. So keep this in your mind. Second thing, audible frequency. In audible frequency, you are aware of 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz. Does it mean the signal, they are not available below 20 hertz and above 20 kilohertz? The signals are available. So 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz called as audible signal. Before 20 hertz, it is infrasonics, and about 20 kilohertz, it is ultrasonic. So infrasonic and ultrasonic, both the signal we cannot listen, we cannot hear with your, we cannot listen it. Try to understand this thing. Likewise, for eyes, below and above, 380 nanometer to 780 nanometer. Okay, so 380 nanometer to 780 nanometer. This is only the allowed range with our eyes. So in the same thing, the visible communication or color or black and white transmission is going on. Now one more graph is shown over here. It clearly indicates that the spectrum, if you see 550 to 600 nanometer, in this range you will find a peak, and this peak color is indicating green. What is the meaning of this? When you see any scene with open eyes, then it dominates the green color. That means when you see the green color, the maximum stimulation will be available on your retina of eye, or your eye response is maximum to green color, and it gradually decreases for rest of the color. That is what the indication of this graph. Next, there are two types of color theories. Number one, additive mixing, and number two, subtractive mixing. Additive mixing, the primary colors are red, green, blue, and the secondary colors are cyan, magenta, and yellow. They are called as complementary color. So there are two theories basically, additive mixing and subtractive mixing. So normally in television transmission, we are going to concentrate upon additive mixing. So what is it? Now, for that, you have to understand this basic and fundamental formula. This formula, if you understand, all the calculation can be done very easily with the help of this formula. Please keep this in your mind. So what is this formula? 30% red plus 59% green plus 11% blue is nothing but a white signal. This white is normally indicated as a capital Y, called as luminance signal. And that, what is the meaning of this? If 30% red signal, if you take 59% green and 11% blue, the overall output will be a white or luminance signal. Second thing, if you add red and green color in this percentage, 30% red and 59% green, you will get yellow. If you take 59% green and 11% blue, you will get cyan signal. And if you add 30% red plus 11% blue, you will get a magenta color. So what is important thing is, if you add red, green, blue in this percentage, you will get a white color. That is what indicated in this figure. 30% red plus 11% blue plus 59% green, you will get a white color. And if you add this percentage from primary colors, you can get a complementary colors, like red plus green is equal to yellow, or red plus green is equal to yellow, green plus blue is equal to cyan, and blue plus red is equal to magenta. So this is a master formula. W is equal to 0.3 R plus 0.59 G plus 0.11 B. Please keep this in your mind. This is required for further calculation. So if you see this formula, it's very important. W, that is white color. It is also represented as a capital Y. Capital Y indicates a luminance signal is given by 0.3 R plus 0.59 G plus 0.11 B. Not only that, yellow is calculated as red plus green. Cyan is calculated as green plus blue. And magenta is calculated as red plus blue. Please keep this in your mind. So this is called as additive mixing. So if you see, white color is given by 30% red plus 70% cyan. White is equal to 59% green plus 41% magenta. And white is given by blue, that is this blue, plus yellow. So you can write this equation in this form. So this is called as additive mixing. And likewise, white minus R is equal to C. White minus green is equal to M, magenta. White minus blue is equal to yellow. So this is called a subtractive mixing. Other way you can write, white minus cyan, that is white minus cyan is equal to red. White minus magenta is equal to green. And white minus yellow is equal to blue. So these are the formulas which are very important and required for further calculation. Now all of you attention, 6 marks theory question. These definitions are normally asked. Color has 3 characteristics to specify its visual information. These are, number 1, luminance or brightness. This is called as black and white information. Number 2, hue or tint. Number 3, saturation. Okay. So this luminance or brightness information is called as black and white signal. Hue or tint is another definition, and saturation is different. I will tell you how exactly this is to be represented in a given signal, video signal in time domain. Now give attention. Luminance or brightness. This is amount of light intensity as perceived by the eye regardless of the color. Thus on monochrome TV screen, dark red color will be appear as a black, yellow as a white, and light blue color as a gray. So what is this? If you have a black and white television, though the color transmission is going on, the signal dark red will be observed as a black, yellow will be observed as a white, and light blue color will be observed as a gray. Please keep this in your mind. Number 2, hue. This is a predominant spectral color of the received light. Thus, color of any object is distinguished by its hue or tint. So what is this hue? Green leaves have green hues and red tomatoes have red hue. So try to understand. Green leaves have green hue and red tomatoes have red hue. Number 3, saturation. This is the spectral purity of the color light. Saturation indicates how little the color is diluted by a white. A fully saturated color has no white. So hue plus saturation is chrominance. Please keep this in your mind. This doesn't contain any brightness information. For example, vivid green color is fully saturated, and when diluted by white, it becomes light green. So these two information. So if you understand, brightness is black and white signal. And number 2, hue plus saturation is color. So if you see this time domain waveform, so all of you give attention. This is very, very important. This is very, very important. See this. Normally your color television signal looks like this. So if you see this staircase type of signal, this is called as black and white signal for a specific color spectrum. And these lines, they are nothing but a color signal. So color signal plus black and white is your video signal. Please keep this in your mind. And rest of the pulses are there, sync pulse, blanking pulse, color burst and all these things. What is important thing? The amplitude of this color signal is known as saturation. And the phase angle of this amplitude is representing hue. So when we'll do a separate calculation and we will prepare one table based on that, then you will understand that in a color television signal, two different signals are there. One is black and white, another is color. For this color signal, the amplitude of this color signal is nothing but saturation, whereas phase angle is defined for every color is nothing but hue. So hue plus saturation is your color signal. Please keep this in your mind. Next, 6 marks theory question, chromaticity diagram. Okay, what is this chromaticity diagram? As I told you, a result of additive mixing will give you the different colors and color shade. So the practical advantage that it is possible to determine the results of additive mixing of any two or more color lights by simple geometric construction. The color diagram contains all the colors of equal brightness, since brightness is represented by the z-axis. As the brightness increases, color diagram becomes larger as shown. So what is the meaning? Different types of colors, if you add in a different proportion, you are going to get some different color. That is what the chromaticity diagram says. And not only that, the brightness value, three-dimensional representation, the z-axis shows that relative brightness. As brightness increases, the diagram, entire chromaticity diagram increases. So now it will be clarified in this specific field. See this red color. If you are moving from red to green, see the shades. Red, orange, yellowish orange, yellow, greenish yellow, yellow green, yellowish green, and finally green. Now if you consider green and you are moving towards blue, green, bluish green, blue green, greenish blue, blue, and so on. And when you are moving from blue to red in the different proportion, if you add the different color shades which are available, that is blue, purple, purplish pink, and orange. Are you getting this? Purplish pink and finally red. So red, green, and blue, if you add, you will get a white color. So this theory we have already seen. So this is very, very important and known as chromaticity diagram. That different proportions, if you add the color, it will result in another color. Now, all of you give attention. Just now I told you that, let us say in your camera, color television camera, this specific signal is there in front of camera, which consisting of different types of color bands in front of camera. So the same signal you are going to receive in television and you are going to see the same color bar pattern on the display. So what is important thing is, in front of television camera, if the color bar pattern looks like this, white, yellow, then you have cyan, magenta, green, red, black. So this is called as equivalent black and white signal. So for this color bar spectrum in front of camera, equivalent luminance signal or black and white signal will be observed like this. A color signal will be observed like this. And color plus black and white, if you add, you will see a combination. Say at this back end, you will find a staircase. This black and white plus color signal is always sent as a transmitted signal. Now all of you give attention. This is the construction of color television camera. This is the construction of color television camera. All of you give attention. Now, how color television camera works. So these are the parts of color television camera: zoom lens, dichroic mirrors, red, green, blue. These are the filters: red camera, green camera, blue camera. And if you add these colors, 0.3R plus 0.59G plus 0.11B, so you will get luminance signal or black and white signal at output. The prisms are designed as a dichroic mirrors. These dichroic mirrors. Dichroic mirror passes one wavelength and rejects other wavelength. Thus, RGB color images are formed. So these are the function of these dichroic mirrors. And the color filters provides highly precise primary color images. This is what the basic construction of color camera. And after color camera, the amplifiers are then, and you get VR, that is red voltage, green voltage VG, and blue voltage VB. So if you add this, with the help of this register, values are standard, which will give you the formula 0.3R plus 0.59G plus 0.11B. So this is the color TV camera construction one. Okay, next. Now, all of you give attention. If you consider the just now, the camera which I told you, okay? And if you keep, see in front of this camera, if you keep this bar pattern, red, green, blue, okay? If you keep this pattern, red, pink, pale, pink, and if you keep the pattern red, green, blue, yellow, white, what is the meaning of keeping pattern? You take a simple paper on which you just draw these patterns and you just hold in front of your television camera. So how the television camera output voltage will be VR, VG, and VP, that is shown with the help of this diagram. If you put this red, green, blue pattern in front of camera, you will get red voltage like this, green voltage like this, blue voltage like this. If you have red, pink, and pale pink, then you will get such type of combination of red, green and blue voltages. And if you keep such type of pattern, that is red, green, blue, yellow, white. See the third pattern. This is very important. Red, green, blue, yellow and white. So red voltage will be like this, green voltage will be like this and blue voltage will be like this and yellow and white. So yellow, what is yellow? Yellow is nothing but a combination of red and green color. So VR plus VG, at that time VB will be zero. And the white, red plus green plus blue, it will give you a white signal. So what is important thing, such type of color bar patterns, if you put in front of this color television camera, then you will realize this red voltage, green voltage and blue voltages. Now give attention. This pattern is the most important pattern. If you understand this pattern, then it will be easier for you for the further calculation. The standard color bar pattern, white, yellow, cyan, green, magenta, red and blue. So what is this? White is a combination of red, green and blue voltages. So all the voltages are there. So 1.3R plus 0.11.59G plus 0.11B is equal to 1. That is indicated by 1 white. Yellow is a combination of red and green color. So red and green voltage is available. There is no blue voltage. So how much percentage of red and green color? See this. 30% red plus 59% green is going to be a yellow color. So 0.3 plus 0.59, 0.89. So this is yellow color. Cyan, blue plus green. Blue plus green, there is no red. So blue plus green. So if you see this, a blue plus green. So blue plus green is nothing but a cyan. So cyan voltage is given over here. See this cyan, 0.70. So what is the percentage? 0.59 plus 0.10. That is 0.70. Accordingly, this calculation is done. So this is called as equivalent luminance signal. Please keep this in your mind, that if you keep this type of pattern in front of color television camera, then you are going to get individual voltages VR, VB, VG like this, and the luminance signal will be observed like a staircase waveform. So everywhere you go, you will find this staircase waveform. Why? They are considering that you know that such type of pattern is hold in front of a television camera, and hence you are going to get this staircase pattern. Please keep this in your mind. So what is this white? White is 100% white. Yellow is 89% bright, cyan is 70% bright, green is 59% bright, magenta is 41% bright, red is 30% bright and blue is 11% bright. Please keep this in your mind. Next. So as I told you, if you hold such type of pattern in front of television camera, then you are going to see the same pattern on your television. Same pattern on your television. Okay, so this is white, this is red plus green, blue plus green, green, this is magenta, red, blue, this is yellow and this is cyan color. So this is the original color. Please keep this in your mind. Now color TV camera 2, see this. Initially we have just seen that from red, green and blue camera, you are getting a signal called as black and white signal, that is VY. But from this colored camera itself, two more signals are derived and they are called as color difference signal, R minus Y, B minus Y. Because this Y is taken, it is inverted and added to this R and Y. So R minus Y is R minus Y and B minus Y is nothing but B minus Y. So this is luminance signal, and a combination of R minus Y and B minus Y is called as color signal. Please keep this in your mind. So in your color television camera output, always a color difference signal is transmitted. Why to transmit this color difference signal? We will see it afterwards. But keep this in your mind, that two signals are there from the same camera. Number one, a luminance signal, and number two, from the camera itself, it is derived like R minus Y and B minus Y. You can derive G minus Y signal also, but there is a reason that why not to send G minus Y. There is a specific reason to send R minus Y, B minus Y. So color difference signal is always sent, not individual red, green, and blue color. So Y is a luminance signal, and as far as color information is concerned, it is R minus Y and B minus Y. So now, a very important thing which I am going to tell you, that three facts and five questions about your color television transmission and reception. If you understand these three facts and five questions, then it will be easier for you to answer the question based on this color television fundamentals. So give attention. Fact number one. When you consider a color television camera consisting of RGB, individual red, green, and blue colors, they are never transmitted. Please keep this in your mind. Okay. Individual red, green, and blue colors, they are never transmitted. So what they are transmitting? They are transmitting the color difference signal. Please keep this in your mind. They are transmitting the color difference signal, that is R minus Y, B minus Y. This is the first fact. So if you see this spectrum, black and white signal is AM-USB modulated. Sound signal is frequency modulated. But whereas instead of individual RGB colors, they are taking color difference signal, and this color difference signal is QAM modulated. Why individual RGBs are not taken? Can anybody answer? A very simple answer to this question is nothing but if you take three different red, green, and blue signal, three different carriers are required in this spectrum, and it is going to interfere the black and white signal as well as sound signal. To avoid this, okay, to avoid this, engineers, they have taken R minus Y and B minus Y signal. So this is the first fact, that individual red, green, and blue colors, they are not taken. The color difference signal is taken, and this color difference signal is R minus Y and B minus Y. Okay, this is the first fact. Now second fact is, in black and white television receiver, there is no provision to process color television signal. So just now we have seen that color, as far as camera is concerned, camera is transmitting two signals. One is black and white and another is color. In color, R minus Y and B minus Y, color difference signals are sent. So the same signals are received by black and white television receiver. But there is no provision to process this R minus Y, B minus Y. Only Y signal processing stages are there in black and white television. So just try to recall, 2 days before we have taken a lecture in which I told you, I have taught you the block diagram of black and white television. So what I told you over there, in black and white television, have you seen any chroma processing section? No. So in black and white television, there is no provision of chroma processing section. So only Y signal, that is black and white, is taken. It is processed and given to the black and white television CRT display. So this is fact number two. So what is fact number two? Though the received signal at a black and white television receiver, they are Y, R minus Y, B minus Y. The spectrum is shown over here. See this, AM-VSB modulated, black and white, then FM modulated audio signal, and QAM modulated color signal. Though these signals are available at the input of black and white television, in black and white television only there is a provision to process Y signal. There is no chroma processing section. Hence Y signal is demodulated, that is AM-VSB demodulated, amplified. and given to the cathode of black and white television picture tube. Hence, the output of black and white television picture tube will be black and white only. So this is fact number two. Fact number three, in color television, what is happening? In color television receiver, Y, R minus Y and B minus Y. All these signals are available. So Y is AM VSB modulator, R minus Y, B minus Y, that is QAM modulated. All these signals are available. So there is a provision in color television receiver to process Y, R minus Y and B minus Y. So what is that provision? Y is processed, that is AM VSB demodulated, and Y is available. The Y signal, it was AM VSB modulated. So in color television receiver, it is AM VSB demodulated. So Y is available. In color television receiver, R minus Y, B minus Y signal was QAM modulated. So QAM demodulator is used in initial stage in chroma section. So once you use QAM demodulator, R minus Y, B minus Y is available. There is an attenuator circuitry from which G minus Y is directly recovered, that is from R minus Y, B minus Y. So R minus Y, B minus Y, G minus Y, it is available. And you just add this Y. So RGBs are available in chroma section. And this RGB is given to the color picture tube cathodes, and hence the color signal is observed. Please keep this in your mind. So in black and white television, there is no provision for color signal processing, but in color television receiver, there is a provision to process black and white signal as well as color signal. And this color signal is given to the color picture tube. So what is the main difference between black and white and color television? In black and white, there is no provision to process color signal, and the picture tube itself is a black and white. And as far as color this color television is concerned, compared to black and white television, as I told you, there are two things which are different. Number one, the chroma processing section is completely different compared to black and white television. And number two is color television picture tube. So these are what the two main differences of this color television compared to black and white. Okay, this is what fact three. So fact one, fact two and fact three we have covered in today's lecture. And now in next lecture, we will cover the different five questions. So these are those questions, question 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That is, if monochrome picture is being transmitted, then how color signal, that is R minus Y and B minus Y, are zero at transmitter end itself. Question 2, why R minus Y, B minus Y signals are sent? Why not G minus Y? Question 3, how color signal spectrum is adjusted in same luminance signal frequency band within that channel itself? So what is the concept of frequency interleaving? Question 4, then how will be the typical color transmitter and receiver look in block diagram form? And question number 5, how time domain waveform for Y, that is luminance and color difference signal, will be observed? So all these points we will cover in our next lecture. Thank you very much.